Hi all, happy news to all the Google Meet users. Why in the sense because the Google Meet recently they updated in the case of user interface. They changed a lot of modification in the case of the user interfaces. That user interfaces are very much attractive as well as very powerful also. So we can see the demonstration. Before that, just I'm going to give one more input. If you need to explore or if you need to use the previous legacy experiences of the Google Meet, it's nothing but the previous template or previous Outlook you want to see. They provide the chances for us up to the June 10. So if you want to use the previous template or previous view of the Google Meet, we can access that particular view up to the June 10. For this, we have to go to the right side corner, use the legacy experience for this call. Once you click here, automatically we can move to the previous Outlook or previous user interface. Suppose you like to explore the new features, what you have to do, instead of clicking the use the legacy experience for this call, we can go directly to the join now, as we already joined previously. The same mode, you can go for join now. Once you click the join now, automatically it leaves the Google Meet page. Now you can see this Outlook. So every main options available in the center only. See here, all the main features is available in the center. So look like the other tools like a Zoom or WebEx, no? So they also giving the main the functions of the particular tool is in the center only. The similar manner, they also modifying the things. So this is, we already familiar with this symbol, is called turn off microphone. And they're given one more shortcut also, the parallel, that's called control D. Suppose you want to turn off your microphone, you can press the control D. So this is a shortcut also they provide. And this button turn on or turn off option is available in the center itself. Turn off camera, the next button. So there is a shortcut also they provide, that's called control E. Suppose I like to close my camera, you can go with control E, automatically my camera will be closed. If I want to open the same camera, web camera, once again I can press the control E. Once I press the control E, so my camera might open, so it takes few minutes to open my camera. So now we can see the camera. So this option, turn off camera. And previously we used the turn on captions in the right corner. You might see that previous template, the turn on captions in the right, but now there's given is the near to the turn off or turn on the camera itself. There they given us a turn on captions shortcut as a C. So you can press the C option automatically. The what are the things that spoken by the resource person or the participant, you can see the captions. For this we can use the C option. And this is for the present now options. Generally in the previous cases of the Google Meet interface, that present now options, it comes to the right corner. The right corner of now. But now they keep it that present now options in the center itself near to the turn on captions. So if you want to present your screen, click the present now. So the similar way, the previous view also, the previous user interface, they given the three mode. One is called your entire screen. If you want to share your screen, the entire screen, you can go to this option. You want to share only the window, like PowerPoint window, you can go with a window. Suppose you want to share any kind of YouTube, particularly if you want to share any video or animation, you can depends on the get tab mode. So I hope you're already familiar with this, that's why I'm skipping it. The next important option is called more options. So generally in the case of the more options, the previous user interface, it comes to the right corner. The right corner, the down, you might see these three dots. But now they incorporate these three dots in the center itself. If you click this more option, we can find out this option called whiteboard. I hope you know how to generate the whiteboard link, Jamboard link. Once you click here, automatically there's a pop-up menu, it comes to the right side. Suppose you want to create a whiteboard, you can click a start a new whiteboard. Once you click the start a new board, it has to be share this link, otherwise that whiteboard might come here. This here chat message, it goes to the participants. So previously the chat is available in the right color corner, the right top corner, but now see there's a chat, it comes to the right corner in the down, the right corner of the down, that's called chat with everyone. So previously it was in the up, now it's they put in the down. So you can see this, there is a Jamboard link. And there are other features also, there are more options available. If you click the more options, you can see the other options like change layout. Suppose you want to change the layout of the auto mode, tiled mode, or spotlight, or sidebar. So which you want, you can modify it. And similarly, there is a full screen option. Suppose you want to see this entire screen of the Google interface in a full screen mode, you can click the full screen, automatically there is a full screen mic comes. If you want to come back to the normal view of your Google Meet, you can press the escape button on your keyboard. Automatically it might reach the previous view of your normal Google Meet view. Then similarly, other features also I'm going to highlight. Change background. I hope you're already familiar with the change background. If you click the change background, this is for the turn off the background. This is for the blur, light blur. This is for the blur your entire background. This is if you want to add a new virtual background screen, you can use this plus symbol. Otherwise, they given already some kind of pre-existing some templates of the background. You can use this also. So that is the part of the background. And see this next features. If you click the next features, you can see this option called captions. It's already there in the case of the near to the turn on turn off captions. It's also there in the center button itself. If you want, you can use this also. Suppose you want to give the any problem, if you want to report it, you can go with the report your problem. If you want to report any abuse of the meeting, you can report it. Troubleshooting, if you have any issues, you can claim here, you can check the help here. And if you want to modify the settings of audio, you can go with the settings. This is for the audio and video. This is for the general setting. So this is generally it happened in the right side corner of the down, but now they're incorporating everything in the center. So this is a very good look. It's looking very attractive also. And the left corner, in the left corner, you can see this time. Now is 10:51 p.m. That's why you are seeing this 10:51 p.m. And this is our code. That's our Google Meet code. That's also it comes to the left side. And see the right corner, you can see this voice. So whenever you are speaking, no, automatically detecting. Okay. So from this, we can check whether our voices reach the audience. For this, we have to verify from this kind of icon. And these are the options. One is called meeting details. Suppose you want to more about the meeting details, click this meeting details and you can see this other meeting details like copy joint information or the link details, everything you can see from here. Then this is called the people option. If you want to know who are joining our meeting, you can click the show everyone. Once you click the show everyone, we can see these other people. Similar way, the previous also we have the mute as well as the pin the screen, that option is also available. This is for the pin options. If you want to meet the people, if you keep the cursor in the above the person, you can find out the mute. That's only the possible beside the host. If you are the host, you can you can mute that people. Suppose you want to add the people, you want to invite other people as a guest, you can click add people and write that mail ID. From this they may connect us. So this is a way we can connect the people. And this is a box is for the chat. So the previous cases, the people and chat is available in the right top corner. It is available in the top. Now they put it to the down, everything. So all the functions, all the main functions of the Google Meet is now available in the down itself. So therefore, you don't have the confusion about the whether it's a wrap or down, because all the functions of the Google Meet, it may comes from down only. Therefore, we can easy to access that particular options or particular function which you need. Very fastly we can access it. Because everything is to be down controlled, everything we have the down control only. And this option called activities. Suppose you want to create a whiteboard. I'm using a normal Gmail account, that's why you cannot find any kind of polling section on that. Suppose if you are using the Google Workspace education or Google Workspace interfaces account, you can see we can add some kind of polling section. That times if you have that account, you might see that kind of activity also, that you can generate that kind of activity. So thanks to the Google Meet to incorporate such wonderful features. While we want to leave this meeting, we are clicking the center button also, the previous user interface also. But in the same mode, now they given us this is a button as a center they given after the more options. If you want to leave the meeting, kindly press leave the call. Once you press the leave call, we can leave from this meeting. Suppose you want to rejoin once again the same meeting, what we have to do, we can click the rejoin. Once you click the rejoin, you can go to the same Google Meet view. Suppose I like to explore, I want to see this previous Outlook. So just now I explored the new Outlook. You like to go with the previous Outlook, instead of going to join now, go to the use the legacy experience for this call. So once you click the legacy experience of this call, it moves to the old view. After that, press the join now. Once you press the join now, you can view the previous views. Now we can see the previous view, the chat, the people, then activities, everything in the right top corner. Then you can see this is an turn off the camera, turn on the microphone. Then this is for the leave the call. This is for the turn on caption person now. This is for the more options. So this is a old tempo. Share my sincere thanks to the Google Meet to modify that entire Outlook, that entire user interface Outlook. Damn sure it make much attraction towards the use of the Google Meet. Thank you, Google Meet. Bye.